Hello, welcome to Practically Employed. I'm G, and today I'm going to be talking about the 23andMe DNA test. If you don't know what it is, 23andMe is a company where you can send them a sample of your DNA if you purchase the package from their website, and then they will go and analyze it in the research labs and tell you basically what your genetic heritage is and try and match you with people who might have that, like similar strands of DNA and different things like that. A lot of people like to do it because it helps them know a little bit more about their makeup and their history and a lot of things they might not have known, which is why I'm doing it. So this is the box that it comes in, you can see. And then on the back, it has a three-step process, which I'm going to be completing throughout this video. So the first step is to go and register your kit. So you just have to go onto their website. I already did that part. All you really have to do is fill out your email, your personal information, and then you have to verify your email. So let's open it up. So this is what is on the actual inside of it, if you can see. So there are a lot of rules you have to follow. The big one is that you can't have any food or drink for 30 minutes before doing the test itself. This is the kit itself. And then this is what the back looks like. This is the tube itself. So you spit right into here and then it goes to this fill line. So you only actually need about like this much of saliva. It also says that most people take 2 to 5 minutes to spit. Interesting. I wonder where they got their data from. So, just gonna spit. I'm only halfway. It's so weird to think that, like, just scrounging my mouth for saliva right now, and it's like I'm just searching for my heritage. I'm just gonna spit into this and then send it away and they're gonna tell you who you are or who you thought you were. Okay, I think I've reached this spill line. I'm gonna show it up close for anyone who thinks that this, they might want to skip this part. So there it is. You can see that the bubbles went over. So this liquid on this side is gonna mix with my saliva. Not sure what it does. I'm sure they know in their research labs. But basically, I have to hold it upright. Oh, there's the click. Okay, so, oh, there it goes. Yeah, you can see it mixing. Interesting. Oh, okay. So now that is put to the side. So I screw this part on tightly. Just a regular little piece of plastic screw. And then it is now screwed on and I just have to shake it. It says for 5 seconds. Probably mixing the liquid, I guess, fully. I can't imagine it's not gonna shake for 5 seconds in the mail, though. Okay, so this is the bag. So I'm guessing that this is the pad, probably like a moisture absorbent pad. So it said to open it. And it even warns you again on the front of the bag that you should not have the other lid on top. Which is important because obviously you would need to shake it for 5 seconds and you couldn't do it with that lid. Okay, so slide that in there. Now it says peel to expose the adhesive. So let's peel that. It's okay if you drop it because it sealed itself. Right, and it is in there and all I will have to do is put it back in the box. And then peel here and close the back It has the information from the company, so you can literally just put it right in the mail from there and send it on its merry way. So the results are in, and I finally have my DNA ancestry results from 23andMe. So I'm gonna take you guys on the website and show you around how to use it and what came back for me. This was a really exciting process for me because my whole life I thought I was just 100% Italian. This came back something a little bit different than a full purebred Italian. So you guys are gonna have to stay tuned to see what my results say. So let's look into it. So as you can see, right here it says 72.5% Italian, so I am still Italian for the most part. But if we click on this, it will load and you can see what my full breakdown of all of my DNA is. So GG, that's me. So I'm 84.2% European, 14.9% Middle Eastern and Northern African. This was crazy to me how high of a percentage it was. I mean, I kind of assumed it would be some kind of Middle Eastern, but the fact that it's Middle Eastern and Northern African and 15%, I felt like that was a lot for someone who just grew up thinking they were just fully Italian. So if we click in, it breaks it down. So here's the Italian, and then Balkan, broadly Southern European is 5% or 5.4%, and then 5%. Balkan, Northwestern European is 0.2%. Ashkenazi Jew and broadly European. And then in the Middle Eastern, so it's actually 10%, 0.1% Middle Eastern. So the majority is Middle Eastern, and then it's 2% Northern African and broadly Middle Eastern, Northern African. So there's some crossovers in there. So if you click into them, it gives you a little bit of a bio of what it means when they say Northern African or when they say Middle Eastern, which is super cool and super interesting for someone who wants to learn more about their heritage or what their DNA results actually mean. I thought it was super intuitive because I'm clicking through thinking, I don't know anything about that, I want to know more. And so a lot of the information is in there in their website for you. And if you saw on the first page, so yeah, it says 23andMe's ancestry composition will update up with 120 additional regions, which will be coming soon to all customers, which is super cool because even though this was something that I had done a couple months ago and I just got my results back, yes, it does take that long for your results to come in sometimes, they're still updating their system, so who knows what it's going to have 2 years from now. And to be clear, I used the basic 23andMe package, so I didn't get anything with the health health reports, but you can update after you've done the test. So if 5 years from now or next month even, I decide that I want the results of what my DNA says about my health, I'll be able to go in, pay an extra price to upgrade, and get all of that information, which is nice because who knows, maybe I will want it or will change my mind and am curious about what those results are too. It gives you your ancestry timeline. So obviously mine Italian, like I had assumed, but it says most likely had one grandparent or great-grandparent who was 100% Italian, and this person was likely born between 1910 and 1970. So this was super interesting because you could go through and see like, someone Middle Eastern was 1950 to 1910. It gives you these estimates for when they think these people who were purebreds of that heritage were born. Just gives you a little bit more insight, especially if you don't know anything about your family tree. I'm fortunate, my whole family loves making a family tree, so we've been digging deep trying to find all of our relatives to build our tree out, but this also gives us some insight of who may have been Middle Eastern or Balkan or Northern African to see where these roots might have come from. And also can click in and it can tell you more about how to interpret these results. And then it breaks down your like actual DNA, so if you like move your mouse over it,
it will single out certain things, and it's what each one, like, colors represent, like, which part they come from. So if you can see East Asian, is that's it. That's the only part of me that is East Asian. Number 16, tiny little bit right there. But it's interesting because it can kind of put things in perspective. So if I did Italian, you can see how much of my DNA shows that I'm Italian. So if we go back, you can view your maternal haplogroup, and it puts you into a DNA subgroup. And it gives you kind of what they estimate, where if a person was living today, could trace his or her own maternal line back over thousands of generations, all of our lines would meet a single woman who lived in Eastern Africa between 150,000 and 200,000 years ago. It goes on to a whole story about that, and about what your DNA haplogroup is, and more details on how to understand it. What is super cool is that it shows your DNA family. So it says I have 1,054 DNA relatives. I'm not gonna click on this only because even though they allowed me to see their names on this list, I don't wanna go and put anyone else out there who may not want to be a part of this video. So if you do click on this, it basically just shows you a network of how to click in and see what percentage related that you are, and what, if they have made it available, what their DNA results were, so you could see maybe where you crossed over. It does tell you if you're cousins, if you're half cousins, if you're uncles or siblings or anything like that. So it's really intuitive about how you're related and who you're related to. And there's a whole messaging software so you can connect with people or reach out to them if they're more private, especially if they don't have any information, but it says you're very related. You could still reach out, and they just have the option to ignore your message or to accept your message. I found it super easy to use and really interesting, considering there's 1,000 people out there that matched with my DNA just from doing one software. There's a bunch of different DNA tests, so it makes me curious about if I have that many people on other DNA tests as well. But it's super user-friendly and definitely worth it for if you're trying to connect with people. But I wouldn't suggest it over one or the other because it's all about who did what brand DNA test. But it definitely was intuitive, and I definitely was able to find people that I didn't know I was related to. It also tells you how many people per country and where a lot of your relatives might have emigrated to. So I thought that was interesting because it kind of can give you a judgment about where you might have a lot of family or where people might still live today or have moved to. So below the DNA family, there is the Neanderthal ancestry. So I am 246 variants of Neanderthal, which is less than 85% of 23andMe customers. I thought it was interesting. Yeah, I placed first out of my family and friends because it's just me right now. So yeah, as you guys can see, I have zero variants to have straight hair. I don't have straight hair, so they're correct. I thought that was funny, but it is interesting. My only one was you have one Neanderthal variant is associated with having less back hair. I don't have back hair, in case you're wondering. I am not that tall, so I don't have anything associated with a high height. I love dark chocolate, but don't sneeze a lot when I eat it, so they weren't wrong there. I just thought it was interesting that they include that, and that somewhere they're able to calculate this and have it for their users. You can see it's a super easy website. Say cheese, you can add a picture. Personalize everything so that way if you are trying to find different family members, they'll be able to recognize you or at least see you before you are able to connect with them. And then research, it's going to be more for the surveys we were talking about, and you can make a family tree within 23andMe, and it's super useful if you have other relatives who also did the DNA test through this program, so you can just connect right in there, which will put your DNAs together and it'll tell you how much you are technically related based on what your DNA says. So yeah, that's about it for how to use the 23andMe website and what my ancestry report was. It definitely was an awesome experience for me, so I highly recommend it to anyone who is curious about what their DNA says about them. That's all I've got for this week. I hope you guys like this style of video. I know it's out of the kitchen, but it's still interesting, and from time to time I like to do a little bit more lifestyle videos. So give me a thumbs up if you like something different for this week. Comment below if you want to see more different things or what those different things are. And subscribe to my channel for more content. Next week I'll be back in the kitchen, so feel free to check me out then.